Hi, my lovely lattes. This is Sherry with LiveLoveLatte.net, and thank you for joining me for another organization video. I recently went camping with some friends and my family to Idlewild, California, and I thought maybe I'll do a video on how I organize for family camping. There are all types of camping. We do a lot of family camping where there's a campsite, it's in a state park, maybe two tents per campsite. There's a fire pit, there's a picnic table, coin operated or shower, token operated showers, flushing toilets that are, you know, just a distance away from the campsite. So that's the kind of camping I'm going to show you in this video of how I pack for that or how I organize for that. And so what I do is I have these types of bins. These are from Costco. And in this video, I'm just going to show you how I pack for dining and kitchen. And that's what the label says here. My first tip in packing or organizing for a family camping trip is to have a checklist. Now, I've perused the internet. I can't remember, maybe about 20 to 30. I mean, I looked at a lot of checklists because I knew I wanted one to finally be like kind of a permanent checklist for me. I've always written it down by hand and brought the checklist with me, and so I decided to go with REI. They have a lot of checklists on their website, and it's a very good checklist. I've been camping for 10 years with my family camping, and through trial and error, seeing all this whole list, it's really is how we camp for family camping. So even here it says this list is intentionally extensive. Not every chef will bring every item on every trip, right? But it's a good checklist, and the ones that you don't need, that doesn't suit your family, you don't need to bring it. So there's other checklists maybe that you can recommend to me. I've seen ones, you know, they're colorful, they have pictures of tents, it's really cute. But I decided to go with this one from REI.com. This is the Camp Kitchen Checklist. So that's what I'm going to show you today. And it goes to hardware basics, kitchen deluxe, things you may want to bring in the morning, midday, evenings. So it's just one page, and I just stick it inside the bin on the top. So let me show you what's inside the bin. Okay, when you open it up, you see that I pretty much used every inch that I could in these bins because, you know, the car space is limited. Usually, I mean, we've gone all places for camping. We've been to Mount Zion in Utah. We've been to the Grand Canyon several times. We've been to different parts of Arizona, so you know we've done enough camping where you have to really use every piece of real estate that you can and really make it intentional as far as what you're going to bring. And so what I do is for the dining camping, I'm going to show you. This is one of the things that I got a while back from Walmart that is probably one of the best things that I've ever gotten for camping. I just put a label there, dining, and what it is, it was, it was probably $10. I've just closed the two sides with these key rings, and it holds, it's like a picnic set. And since we are a family of four, this works perfectly. They're in different colors, you know, blue, yellow, red, green. And these are the dishes. So see, they're shallow and they fit on top. So it makes a good use of the space. There are coordinating colors for the cups, and these are both for hot and cold. I put in a Ziploc some napkins, paper napkins, that are good for at least a day. I put about two napkins per person per meal. And then these are Sicily's old toddler forks and spoons that I covered the top with Ziploc, and I wrap it with a rubber band. And what I found is that on a camping trip, you always need Ziploc, you always need rubber bands. It comes in handy, okay? And then I went and got these. These are also four different colors. This is enough for forks and spoons for four people. And then this one has, you know, the fork on one end, the spoon on the other, and then this has kind of a jagged edge for cutting. So I put that in a little snack size Ziploc. And then at the bottom, you can see here, these are the same type of plates, but they're actually kind of like bowls. You see they're a little bit deeper than the plate. So we use this for bowls because, yeah, we eat soup on camping trips, especially at night when it gets cooler. We've had clam chowder, chicken noodle soup, Filipino soup that we like to make. And so that's that. And it just fits so wonderfully in this container. And the other great thing about this container is this can be your kitchen sink. You can fill this up with water, use your biodegradable soap, and wash dishes in here. And then this can be a place to hold the, you know, the clean dishes. So they know these are, this is for dirty dishes, you know, at the campsite. These are for dirty dishes. My family knows to put it there, and then to put the clean dishes here. And just a tip, you know, my son, through the years, he's become the dishwasher on camping trips. So that's his responsibility, and he knows that. He does a great job too. The other thing that I bring, not all the time, are just some extra smaller plates. Of course, like I showed you earlier, we have plates that we wash and we use, and it's just better for the environment. But I bring these because if you're camping with other families, maybe your four campsites all together, of course, you're going around eating each other's food. There's always enough food when you're camping with other families. So I just bring, you know, enough to, let's say, to offer three meals for other people. Let's say for a family of four for three meals. So, you know, you want to be hospitable and share your food. So I just bring that. And then I also bring extra bowls. And I bring these plastic bowls that, you know, we've used through the years. And, you know, the sets are gone or they've been destroyed or used up. But I keep them for camping. And these are for the times when I'm serving soup, you know, and of course someone will come by and they're like, oh, I want some clam chowder. And of course you're going to give that, or you want to offer a bowl of chili. And I've used paper bowls before, and I prefer to have these plastic bowls versus the paper. So I bring these, and then I just have an extra bag of paper napkins. Again, this is, I've divided them again, two napkins per person per meal, and that would be for another, you know, two sets of those. And like I said, putting things in Ziploc is perfect, one, for organizing, but secondly, on a camping trip, if you have like extra food or things you want to contain, it's good to use a Ziploc. These forks, right? Camping forks, where they extend so that you can be far away from the fire. You can use these for hot dogs and definitely s'mores, my favorite, and everybody's favorite, right? So it's a, they usually sell them in a pair of two, in a pair, and they're relatively inexpensive. If we're camping with other families and other campsites, I bring an extra set of forks, spoons, and knives. Again, I do the same thing. Put the tops in Ziploc, wrap it with a rubber band, and I do this again. It's the sharing thing. This is the other thing that I put in this bin is this shoebox, and I've just labeled it kitchen prep. What's in what it holds is a mini cutting board. You can get this in the camping section, and then I have a pot holder set. This is from the Dollar Tree, and I have a carabiner. And the reason I put these on a carabiner is that when you're at the campsite, I hook it onto either a little branch on the tree, onto our table, and so it's just more handy there. Instead of using real estate on the table, you want to leave that as open as possible for preparing food and putting the dishes there and putting the stove. So the carabiner really helps in all types of things that you do for camping. And then I always put a hand sanitizer near the kitchen prep area for the cook, for people who are about to eat. So we always wash our hands as much as possible, and then I just have hand sanitizer just to make sure our hands are clean, and or if they didn't have a chance to go wash their hands. So that's a good thing to have. I have measuring cups all the way from a quarter teaspoon to a cup. Now, I don't bake on on camping trips, or you know, maybe I'm making a recipe that requires some measurement, but most of my recipes or most of the stuff that I serve during camping isn't gonna totally need some measuring spoons or cups, but I bring them just in case I have needed them in the past. And as far as menu planning, I always plan just like I do at home. I plan for every breakfast, lunch, and dinner and snacks for the whole camping trip. If I'm sharing with another family, let's say dinner is one time my friend's turn, and another, like maybe all of Friday is my turn and all of Saturday is her turn. And so we plan that out. You have to just plan that out beforehand. Either way, it works out for me. Here's a spoon for sure for soup. And this is for flipping pancakes. You need, and I make sure I get the Teflon one. And then I got this knife. This is from Costco, and it's a great knife, and it has a cover, and it's very light, and it's thin, it's not bulky. So that knife, and then there's this smaller knife, also with a cover, and you can see the different uses that you can do with that. I always have a clip for the bag of chips, some tongs, and these are just older ones. I'm probably gonna get one with the, you know, that's good for Teflon. Of course, a lighter for the stove, a can opener. This is from the Dollar Tree. Bottle opener, corkscrew, you know, bottle opener there, corkscrew, because who hasn't had wine when you've gone camping, right? I have. Okay, and then there's that little knife. So this is the Dollar Tree, just a dollar. And then I usually have you know, for tossing salad, or if, for spaghetti. Yep. When we eat or we cook for camping, it's just like the food that we have at home. Sometimes we have special stuff, but I don't just open up a can or open up those freeze-dried things and toss it on a plate. I plan a real menu. So, and this is from Coleman. It's just a salt and pepper shaker. And then in the Ziploc, I have my tablecloth. So for sure, this is one of the, you know, the errors that I've made in the past is I forgot a tablecloth or I didn't bring a tablecloth. And those picnic tables at the campsite, they are dirty. They're pretty gross, okay? If you bring your own table, you can always wipe it down. At the kitchen prep area, I don't put any tablecloth. So it's, you know, it's a plastic table, always wipe it down. But the wooden picnic table, they're gross. You have to have a tablecloth. And I have, you know, the tablecloth clips. A lot of times these don't work because the picnic tables are really thick, but you can always put stuff at the four corners to keep it down. Okay, so that's one shoebox. The other thing that I bring is a roll of paper towels and a little box of aluminum foil. So, of course, paper towels to do a lot of cleanup, and the aluminum foil to cover food and to grill. A tip I have for you as far as menu planning is to make food ahead of time. So, example, we like to have Filipino chicken adobo, which is soy sauce chicken, and I prepare that at home, freeze it in a Ziploc bag, and then on the day of camping, I usually do the food prep the day before, and then we just take the food that's in the Ziploc out of the freezer and put it into our igloo with ice, and then at the campsite, all we have to do is heat up the food instead of, you know, cutting and cooking. Other things you can do is like beef stew. I've done spaghetti and meatballs, and then I just cook the spaghetti there at the campsite. Anyway, here, this shoebox has a bath and cleaning. So inside, this is one of, I just purchased this for our last camping trip, and such a great buy. Okay, it's a double, it's a collapsible, I hope you can see this, a collapsible double sink. Okay, so it looks like that, and you see how it collapses. So what, like I said, my son is the dishwasher. Well, it has two handles, okay? So you just, you know, one side can put the dirty dishes and pots and pans in there, and then the other is for rinsing. And I'll show you in the other video the tank that we have as far as like the kitchen faucet, right? So that's one. And right now I ordered biodegradable soap. We ran out the last time, but you need dishwashing liquid. I ran out at camp, so I ran out and bought this, but I ordered the soap online. Biodegradable is the best. You can use it for washing, you can use it for bathing, although we bring our own soap also, but you can use it for bathing. These are just small camping sponges that I put in a snack size Ziploc bag. This is one of those, you know, from Cost Plus World Market, just a shopping bag that folds into itself. So that's nice sometimes if you want to corral like maybe the bag of chips or other snacks that you have in there. If you want to go on a day picnic, you can use this to transport that that food. These are water cleaning pellets, hydration reservoir cleaning tablets. Okay, then I have a little dustpan to, you know, I use it to clean off the picnic table. And these are kind of like chamois. Yeah, that's the word, chamois. And then I have travel towels. And what you do, what I do is I just went through, like, let's say the camping section of Walmart is great. Of course, REI is great. I just go through those aisles, go look at each item one by one, and think about, is that something that me or my family or I need? And then these are just rags, kitchen towels that we use. Of course, they look dirty, but they're clean. And you know, when we, before we pack everything at camp, we wash everything. My son and I wash everything. When we get home, we wash everything again. The plates, the bowls, the flatware, the stove, everything. And then this is a camp shower. You hook it on here, you know, use a carabiner, hook it onto the tree, put water inside, and the sun's supposed to heat up the water. And then there's this spout. Totally works. I used it one time. We were in Havasupai Falls in the Grand Canyon. There are no showers or flushing toilets, so I used that to, you know, if you kind of wash your, you use this camp soap. There's sheets. They're biodegradable, and I use that shower to wash ourselves off. That was nice. And of course, moist towelettes. So that's another shoebox inside the bin. Okay, and then the last one is, I just basically listed everything down with a label maker's cover for the cell phone, sleeping, which is the clock, glow sticks, matches, Ziploc, and trash. So I just get about 10. I get about two trash bag, kitchen trash bags per day that we're going to be at camp. We get the trash bag that where it has the handle where you can pull it closed, and I hang this on a branch in the tree and just wrap it around with rubber band. I got a couple extra grocery bags for clothes or dirty shoes, and then some more extra Ziploc. These are the sandwich size, and then I have the gallon size. Okay, and then this are those picnic, the food umbrellas. Again, just to make it so it doesn't get so dirty when it's being transported. I put it in a Ziploc, and there's three of them, and you pull it up. You pull it up to, it becomes like an umbrella, and you cover the food so that the bugs and the flies don't get on it. And then to put it away, you just push that and it folds down that way, like a food umbrella. Okay, and then each of us has a cell phone holder, you know, so, you know, if we're hiking for the day, walking around, I just like them to have their cell phones in a cover. I also have whistles and compasses for us, so it's a place that they can store that if my husband wants to put cash in there or cards. You know, it's always with you. You don't have to leave it in your tent. And then this one is for my kids. It's kind of a waterproof. It's not meant to be submerged in water. I mean, you can't go swimming with this, with your cell phone at your side. But it's just so it just protects it if water splashes on, can wipe it right away. So that's for cell phones. Then we have glow sticks that we tie around camp. These are waterproof matches in a waterproof container. We got a clock for alarm in case, you know, the cell phone runs out of battery or there's no signal. And then some more waterproof camp matches. Okay, another thing I wanted to show you as far as dining and kitchen is the stove that we use. This has it. This is a single burner and it comes in its own protective case. This is by Coleman. And then this is where you put the fuel. Here's the gas where you turn it on and then you just light it with the fire starter. Okay? And it just very portable. And then we have this griddle pan that fits a two burner stove. Okay? So it just fits on like that. Another thing that I bring on camping trips for the dining and kitchen are roaster pans. I usually get about two per day so that I can put the cooked food in there, example sausages and bacon or spaghetti and meatballs, or sometimes I leave it in the pot, but the ones that I can't leave in the pot I put it in there. Okay, then I have this egg holders. It holds a dozen. It's plastic and it has a little carrying case. You can put hard-boiled or uncooked eggs in there and put it in the cooler. The great thing is that they really keep the eggs from breaking. They kind of have this cushion. I don't know if you can see that. Okay, and I've brought eggs where they're still in the carton or they're still in the plastic carton and they always get wet inside the cooler, and this one works pretty well. Then another thing I have, this is kind of a luxury item for me. It's a napkin holder. They sell these everywhere, but you can have one that holds like the plates and the utensils, and it's prettier on the table. It looks nice. It's easier to access. But again, like I said, this is a luxury. It's not necessary, but it's a nice thing to have once in a while. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed my camping organization video, and we'll see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. LiveLoveLatte.net. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, and Instagram.